We would like to thank all of our patrons for your continued support.
Pretty nice, eh?
We're at the boat today. I brought down all of the foam insulation that we're going to use to build out our custom fridge. Each sheet is 1.5 inches thick, and we'll be doubling it up, so there'll be 3 inches of foam on all sides, which is what all contemporary like refrigeration cold plate units require or call for. Right now we're building it out as an icebox because we can't afford to get the refrigeration unit, but I'm building it out with the consideration of where all of the cold plate mechanisms and everything are going to go. So, but first we got to get, you know, figure out our volume. So today I'm like cut out the rest of the bulkhead and I'm laying in the foam. Once we kind of get it all laid in place, then we'll pull everything out and adhere it all together and put the pieces in. But let's take a look at what I've been playing with. So here's our foam. Most of this is the first layer. This piece is 2 layers deep so far. And this is like mold-proof foam you can get from like any hardware store. It has foil on one side, which is called radiant barrier. It's a radiant barrier foam, which will protect your from the heat of the sun. Also, engines produce like radiant heat, so that helps with that. And this is a single layer. Everything's gonna get 2 layers and then they'll be adhered together with thick carpet tape. Now there is like a little bit of a void because of the shape of the hull under this, which I may fill with spray foam, but I'm not sure yet. Kind of the next step is to, we're gonna build a retaining wall here. Gives us clearance to, we're gonna be replacing this seacock very soon when we haul out in October. So we're gonna have a retaining wall that comes up here to the level of the cabinetry. And then we've got our 3 inches of foam and then the inside of our fridge. So this will be like kind of the stop wall. And our fridge is gonna go from here to there. And as you see, the thickness of this stuff really cuts into your space, but it's not going to cut in as bad as I thought. So we're still going to have plenty of room inside our fridge. So we'll have, you know, there'll be 2 and 3 inches there. There'll be, you know, 3 inches all along the top. And then 3 inches here on the retaining wall. So minimizes our space, that's for sure. But that's what it requires, you know. So, and over here as well. So that's what we're doing today. We're kind of getting all the foam cut out so I can start making templates for the wood of the interior space. And just trying to move forward with this project slowly so that I don't do anything I can't undo. It's the first time I've done it. I watched a bunch of videos, any video I could find of people making custom iceboxes. I have this amazing book, which I'll show you guys later when we get further into the project, that shows how to do it, and kind of following his lead, because the way he explained everything makes sense to me. So, not trying to reinvent the wheel, but trying to get it done right. Now it's time to get back to cutting out this foam and kind of jigsawing it together and see what makes sense. And then we go from there. Camille's about to get ready to cut out the new foam to refit the shape of my new bulkhead that I made today. So let's go ahead and look at that. So there's the little bulkhead template. We're going over this old bulkhead down here. And basically I measured out from this bulkhead to there 12 inches on the top and the bottom to make sure that it's vertically sound, because there's no way to use a level on a boat. And the same thing here, I can't recall this distance, but I just measured from this bulkhead to there top and bottom to make sure that it's plumb. So Camille's going to cut out. You see there's a gap there. She's going to cut it so that these are new. I mean, the new ones fit in there perfect. This is two layers right now. This is two layers, but you see the distance there. We're gaining on our new configuration. Today, the goal is to get all the foam cut for the fridge, get it all set in so that we can take measurements and make some cardboard templates of what the interior space is going to be. So then when we go home, we can cut all of that out of 1/8 inch marine ply and kind of like dry fit it together somehow, bring it in and like set it in place, make sure it fits. Once it fits, then we get to glassing the whole thing. This piece, got it in there snug. Then the second one, so starting to take shape. Now I got to cut out two for this shape and then two for the forward shape of the same sort of thing. So I cut this first piece at 12 inches by whatever this height of the chain was, and I marked this mark here is telling me where my insulation is going to fall up top, so we'll just place it there and then put this in here, determine our angle. That, and then I'm gonna mark this and mark this and then do some registration marks like that, and then this part gets cut off and I save the rest of it. Now line up our registration marks, tape it off. We can go ahead and flip this over and tape this side of here, because that way we make sure we don't cut it off. I've done that before. And I'm just going to use my straight edge here. I always use this top step as my cutting board. It's real chewed up already. Kind of want to coat it in like starboard or something so I have a proper cutting spot. But I don't know if that would make it slippery. So here's our first part. Let's check it out. So there's that part. Now we'll figure out this bottom contour, or angle rather. Figure out this bottom angle. We can patch that very bottom part. Get our Sharpie ready. Go ahead and set this in place. And then we got this here. So this is what we're gonna cut off. And then we can just patch that little hole with some with the straight piece. Make up the difference. So let's see here. It's getting there. Okay. Now we'll just square this up. Set that in there. Bring that down. I think we're in business. Go ahead, draw this on. Got a couple registration marks. All right, so here's our shape. Set it in there. She's falling right on the line. Let's check this out. This is where our top foam is going to be. It sits right on there. So this is the shape of the aft two that we need to cut. It's going to change a little with the second one because it graduates down. So I guess it graduates up back, aft, but either way, it changes shape a little bit over here. So we'll do this one first, and then we'll make the next one a little bit bigger so we can trim it down to the exact size. And then this one down here, the forward one's gonna be quite a bit bigger. But we'll just repeat the same process, making our little cardboard template. Real easy, you can do it with a, you know, any given box. You can find a lot of different shapes this way to cut out kind of anything you need. Okay, so got both of the aft pieces cut. Here's our first one. She sits real pretty. And then the next one, all I did was I cut the exact same shape, but I left a couple inches on the top side, and then I put it in and I drew a line on the back to get it exact same height as this one. Because like I said, that elevation changes as it goes forward. So that's our back section. That's done. And we have two layers here, two layers here, two layers here, and two layers here. We're starting to see our shape. I still have to trim this out. This little bit in notch in a little bit, so that that's where part of the fridge box is gonna go. And now we got to get to doing the same process on our forward section. Okay, got all the foam cut less the top layer, which I won't cut until after I get the box made. So let's take a look at it. This is kind of showing us our what our interior dims are going to be of our finished icebox. And next step is to cut more cardboard templates so that I can take those back home to the wood shop, to the studio, and get all the bits cut out of plywood, marine ply. Kind of dry tack it together with like tacking nails. And then bring it down, see if it fits. If it fits, or if I have to tweak it, whatever. The next step after that is coating everything in unthickened epoxy, giving it a good barrier coat with that stuff, or like penetrating epoxy style, and then glassing everything up. So I'll show you guys where we're at right now. So there's all of our sides. Everything's two layers deep. This is 1.5 inches. So that gives us 3 inches of insulation, which all modern cold plate systems call for. And it's like, you know, top of the line insulation that exists nowadays. No mold, no insects. You know, much better than what was in this boat in the 60s, obviously. Any of these little gaps that are here, we're going to get filled with spray foam. This still, I haven't fastened anything down, but I'll be adhering each of these to one another with carpet tape, double-sided carpet tape. But yeah, there's like a couple little gaps, like this gap will get filled, this gap will get filled. Other than that, that's what we're dealing with. And I think it's big enough that my wife won't abandon ship. But small enough that whenever we can afford a cold plate unit, it'll be able to keep it cool. Okay, so I don't know how long that took me. Hour and a half, maybe, to cut all the cardboard and piecemeal the templates together. But let's go ahead and look at the Frankenstein-esque cardboard that represents the interior space of our soon-to-be fridge. And then, as I said, I'll take these pieces home tonight, and tomorrow morning I'll get up, cut all of these, and like pin nail them together, or you know, somehow put them together so they make a box that's like can be taken apart. Bring it down here and see how she fits, see what's got to be tweaked and stuff. So let's go ahead and check it out. So there you have it. And then I'll show you for scale, that end is like, you know, 11 inches deep basically. And then this other end is about 13 inches deep. And then, you know what, 12 inches, you know, 13 inches across at its greatest point. I think what Camille was saying is she wants the cold plate freezer little part is gonna, we're gonna mount it here. So once we get everything done, I'm gonna be pre-drilling a hole for the future addition of that. So I'm happy with the progress we got today. The kind of chipped away at it over days and days, taking our time. As I mentioned before, I would like to, you know, I'm learning how to do this as I go and designing it as I go. So it's better to just go slow and not destroy a bunch of material. Kind of think about what makes sense. Try to think of things that are gonna come up that you don't know about yet, which is difficult, but you know, a little bit of strategy. Try to guess what's coming in the future. There we go. That's it for today. And it's like, let's see what time it is. It's 8:30, not bad. My wife is hanging out with friends, beer people she's friends with. Drinking beer, and I'm gonna go home and probably work on this, because that's all I do is work. So yeah, time to get to it. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, if it helped you out, give it a thumbs up. It helps us in the algorithm. Leave me a comment if you know something I did wrong, you know, something make my life easier. Or if you just want to say, you know, have something to say about it, look forward to that. I respond to every possible comment I can. So, again, thanks for watching, and we'll get back over here and finish this job up. Flip it over, you got your excess here, you just trim that off. I always use this step as like my cutting surface because it's like already messed up. fuck that up. Okay. Let's try that again.